Father God, I ask you, Lord, to protect us in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We give you all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton, Ontario, Canada. I'm going to talk to you the subject called Deliverance from Witchcraft Attacks. Deliverance from Witchcraft Attacks. Deliverance from Witchcraft Attack or Attacks. There are people who are being attacked by witchcraft and they have no idea. Some they know, some they don't know. Yes. So wherever the witches are, I am going to expose you. So I don't mind about them. So the word of God is I'm protected, and I pray that God will protect each and everyone. It is the word of God. Is that I didn't put the word of God in the Bible. And there is no way that we cannot talk this. We are not going to be afraid and fear that we cannot talk this. And I thank God that God is able to help us and protect us in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, I have a school that we are starting on Monday, and I have a package of teaching about witchcraft. You learn about white witchcraft, red witchcraft, and black witchcraft. Introduction of witchcraft, who is a witch, and a weapon of witchcraft. So we have the packet. If you want to take the course, you are most welcome. We are going to talk about how to hear the voice of God, how to hear God. We are going to talk what is deliverance. We are going to talk about the deliverance. And the course would take 6 weeks. You would discover so many stuff. You would be able to become a deliverance minister. So this is a part of it. I would say a little bit, but the rest you will come to the class because it's a speak. So characteristic of witchcraft. So there's a lot of stuff you need to learn and to know. So as we are one categories of witchcraft, that's where we see. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. So I'm going to read from the book of Revelation. Revelation 22, verse 14 to 15. The Bible says, blessed are those who wash their robes so that they may have the right to the tree of life and they may enter the city by its gates. But outside are the dogs, the sorcerers, the sexual immorality and murders, the adulterers, and everyone who loves and practices falsehood. Jesus have sent my angels to give you this testimony for the church. I am the root and the offspring of David, the bright morning star. So here, the Bible is saying that verse 15, the Bible says, but outside are the dogs, the sorcerers, the sexual immorality. You know, people who are being attacked, that's why I said some people, they are attacked by witchcraft and they are not aware. There's a lot of witchcraft attacks and people are not aware, some of them. One of the most attacks of the witchcraft are sexual immorality. They are adulterers. They are dogs. They are sorcerers. Those are the witchcraft attacks. They are false. They are practice falsehood. People who are being practiced falsehood, they are attacked by witchcraft. People who are doing sexual immorality, they are attacked by witchcraft. Because you are allowed to have your own wife, but you find yourself doing immorality. That is witchcraft. That is witchcraft attack. Now you think that witchcraft attack is different. This is witchcraft attack. Many people that are being attacked. Some people are being witchcraft attacked by living even in human nature. They go and do the different ways. That is witchcraft attacks. So that's why I'm coming to preach to you and talk to you so that you can be delivered from this witchcraft attack. Now, if you look at the Bible from 1 Samuel 15, verse 22. 1 Samuel 15, verse 22. The Bible says, Samuel said, as the Lord has much delight in panting offerings and sacrifice, as in obeying the voice of the Lord, behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to hell than the fat of lambs. For rebellion is as the sin of divination, and in stubbornness is as iniquity and adultery. So rebellion itself is witchcraft. It's a spirit of witchcraft. People who are rebel. If you see people are so stubborn, people who are rebel, they are witchcraft. That is a spirit of witchcraft. Witchcraft attacking them. A man of God, a prophet, called Saul. Saul was attacked by witchcraft, and he became so rebellious. He was not able to reason what God was telling him. That is witchcraft attack. Many people, they are being attacked, and they are not aware. Saul did not know that he has been spells. Witchcraft has been spells. Chants has been placed on him. It was witchcraft in the name of chants. When chants has been placed on a person, it will disgrace you. It will not let you to stay and do the work. They will wait you to do, when you are doing very well, then it will attack you and disgrace you and remove you from the position. When there is a chance, witchcraft attack called chance, when you are being attacked by chance, it will bring you down no matter who you are. Unless you know how to pray and how to put them, how to stop them. Many, many, many people, they are being spells, they are being enchants, and they end up their life miserable. You find a man of God, a pastor, with the congregation, and then this witchcraft attack sent to him, and it ending up, like the book of Revelation said that they end up immorality. You find a prophet. I have experienced what I've seen. A man of God, a prophet, who loves God, who through miracles, whom people cry when they see him, who do miracles and miracles. But when the witchcraft attacking him, this person, after the crusade, after the meeting, after people being healed, he goes to do immorality. I know there was a man in our country. He was very good counseling family. God was giving me a gift of counseling, and he was specialist in family affairs. So he was preaching about family, and women were going, people were going there. At the end, this man, he was spells. He was attacked by witchcraft. He ended up. Those women, single women, who were going to him for marriages, for prayer to get a husband, he started sleeping with them. After that, and then he ended up in prison. Because you can't do that every time. You will reach a time where it is going to disgrace you. That is witchcraft. Revelation, the book of Revelation, has said sexual immorality, sorcerers, dogs, all this is witchcraft. Many people, they are being attacked by witchcraft, and some of them, they don't know. They just take things literally. All they just ignore it. But the truth of the matter, it is witchcraft attacks. So I'm going to pray that God would deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now you see, then Saul said to Samuel, I have sinned. I have indeed transgressed the command of the Lord, your words, because I feared the people and listened to their voice. So Saul didn't listen to God. He listened to the voice of the people. And then he chose good people, good women, and spared them. And God was very angry with him. He made God himself to take away his kingdom because of rebellious. He was attacked by witchcraft. In the book of Matthew 7, verse 22, the Bible says, many will say to me, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name? Cast out the devils in your name, and in your name perform many miracles. Then I will tell them to their face, I never knew you, out of my sight, you and your wicked ways. You see, many pastors, many people, they will go to Jesus and say, Jesus, we did a miracle, we did this and this in your name. Then Jesus will tell them, get away, straight away with your wicked, because they give chance to the witchcraft and they didn't do the right thing. They were false prophets. They were wicked people. They were doing immorality. They were doing evil. So Jesus will say, get out with your wicked ways. So many people, they have no idea who they are. They don't know. They don't know if you are a witch, or you are a red witch, or a black witch, or a white witch. You have no, there's some blind witchcraft. They don't know if they are witchcraft, but they are. You can be a rebellious. You become very stubborn. Don't think that is ordinary. Obedience, the Bible says, obedience is better than sacrifice. Anybody who is stubborn, rebellious, who doesn't want to obey, that is witchcraft attack. That person is being attacked by witchcraft. So, rebellious is as good as witchcraft. And you think a witchcraft is the person who has a tail, or who walks at night, or who fly. You can be a witch and you have no idea. That's why I'm coming to you to pray that God would deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. Many people, many women, many people, they themselves, they are witchcraft and they have no idea. But today, God is coming to deliver you and you will be set free in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm going to pray for you. I have so many prayers that I want to pray with you. Any covenant with the Queen of the Heavens from your place of birth affecting your life and the lives of your family members, I command them to be nullified and be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, I command them be nullified and cut fire and burn to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray any covenant with the Queen of the Sea from your place of birth affecting your life and the lives of your family members, I command them to be nullified by the power in the blood of Jesus. And the name of Jesus Christ, I cast them and I bind them, I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. I pray every witchcraft altar initiating your family members and devoted, I renounce you. I call down the fire of heaven to consume you, crumble you, and to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. Weapon of witchcraft in your body and in the body of your family members, I command them to come out and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Any witchcraft materials, any witchcraft in your body and the body of your family, I command them to catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. You might know, you don't know whether you have witchcraft material, witchcraft in your body, in your life. I command them to catch fire and burn to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God. Any laboratory agents of witchcraft using your family members and as experimental, kill yourself in the name of Jesus. Let them kill themselves and destroy themselves in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. Marine snakes, marine scorpions, marine fish, marine Goliath. Hallelujah. In your destiny, I command them to be destroyed and be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, God. invisible marine ring, bangles hiding inside you and inside your family member, I command them to fall off, roast by fire, and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. I am praying that God will destroy every witchcraft ring. You know, people, they have the ring. You think it is ordinary ring. That is witchcraft ring. When they do like this, they control the crowd, they control people. They have bangled. They put bangled like this. You think it is good, but they are dedicated by the witchcraft. And now they control the crowd, they control you, because there is powers of witchcraft. Therefore, I command those bangles, I command those rings to catch fire and burn to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. Seeds of enslavement in your life, in the lives of your members and your children, I command you to run out and die in the name of Jesus. You know, seeds of enslavement. Enslavement is that sometimes you dream you are sweeping, sometimes you dream you are sweeping, you are working in your sleep. That is the witchcraft seed they have planted in you to become a slave. Sometimes you work in sleep, and that is witchcraft. They make you work for them. So I pray that any seed of enslavement in your life and in the life of your family, your children, I command them to burn, to run out and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Every witchcraft agency destroying your prayer and Bible reading and those of your family, you know, the witchcraft, they will attack your reading. They will attack your prayers. They will make sure that you are not praying. The time you start praying, you feel a lot of pain, you feel sick, you feel tired, you struggle. They come fools. They take the Bible. They take you from reading. After taking the reading, then they will make sure that you cannot be able even to pray, because the devil does not want to pray. He doesn't like prayer. The devil does not like prayer. So he would want to fight you until they remove you from prayer. When they remove you from prayer, then they can attack you. They can do you anything because you are not praying. What the devil fears, or what the witchcraft fear, is prayer. If you are a prayer warrior, the witchcraft cannot do you anything in the name of Jesus. Yes, God, I pray every village witchcraft repackaging sorrow into your life and into the life of your members, into your life and members of your family, I command them to backfire and be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. Arrows of manipulation and intimidation in your destiny and in destiny of your family members, I cast them. I command them to be destroyed and burned to ashes in Jesus' name. Dark divination in the camp of your wealth and the wealth of your family members, disappear by fire in Jesus' name. This is a case. You know, some women or some people can come to your life when you were doing very well, like you had a business, your family has been doing well, no sickness, people have been healthy. And then when this person enter in your life, you start experiencing problem. Problems start coming, piling. You lose your job, you lose your wealth, you lose everything. Those are witchcraft programmed that has coming to you. Therefore, that's why I pray that dark divination in the camp of your wealth and the wealth of your family members, I command them to disappear by fire and be destroyed in Jesus' name. I was praying with a lady, and she was telling me that when there was a lady who was married. When the lady came to the family, their business went down, sickness, everybody was sick, and they were ending hospital. They didn't have this insurance, and they were paying money, they were paying. Now everything is gone. And since that woman came to that home, the home is almost like is scattered. People are fighting, sickness, everything is not right. So they felt like, why is it that this woman, when she was married in this home, why is it things are like this? Because a woman has come with witchcraft and has destroyed everything which is in that home. Therefore, I pray that any witchcraft attack, any witchcraft in a form of anything that is coming to your life, let them be destroyed and burned to ashes in Jesus' name. Yes. Blood of Jesus, fight. Let the blood of Jesus fight on your behalf and release your finances and the finances of your family members from the hands of witchcraft in Jesus' name. Let the blood of Jesus fight for you to release your finances and the finances of your family and the finances of your family members in the mighty name of Jesus. Any witchcraft attacking your finances, attacking the sources of your income, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let them be rendered powerless completely in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every witchcraft coven, bank, getting your placenta and the placenta of your family members, release them and catch fire in Jesus' name. I pray that let them catch fire and be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, God. You whom of the heart, using your placenta and the placenta of your family members. I am talking the placenta because the placenta is the one which connects a mother and a baby. So they know that the placenta has powers, they have life. So that this witchcraft, they can go to the hospital and buy your placenta and you have no idea where your placenta is. That's why I'm praying like that, prayer like that. If you don't know where your placenta is, go to your hospital where you were born, ask them your placenta. They will tell you if they have them or no. That's why you keep watch from today, watch the placenta. If women who are giving birth, watch where your child's placenta is going. You will know that this prayer I'm praying, it is very true. This prayer have been done with a lot of research. Therefore, I know some people, their placenta are in the coven of witchcraft. Some of them who were born home, those witchcraft, they have taken your placenta, they are attacking you, they monitor you, they know everything about you. Any witchcraft spells upon your money, your family members, and sent to the village, you are nullified by the blood of Jesus. Release you and die by fire in the name of Jesus. There are witchcraft spells, they have a spell on your money. That's why you see, when money is being witched, what they do, they will come and take money from you. Because they are the people who are monitoring you, they are the people who are watching you. So they will come and take money, have money. They can give you money. And then you take this money, you take to the bank, or you mix with your money, you put in your pocket. When you put in your pocket, that is it. They will spend and you will lose money. So your money has been witched. That's why it's a good thing to give your tithes and offering so that God can clean that money. The only thing that money can be cleaned from these witchcraft spells and chants is to give your tithes to the church and your money will be cleaned. If you still give to the church and your money still is not cleaned, then call me, bring that money to our ministry. We'll take it to the altar and pray until God will receive them. If your church does not know that, you try and see. Because your money must be cleaned. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is good. God is so good. Any witchcraft spells upon money, your family members and given to evil friends and relatives, you are nullified by the blood of Jesus. Let it release you and die in the name of Jesus. Yes, God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, my God. I want to thank you, Jesus. Every power, every evil power, using placenta and the placenta of your family members to summon your spirit, I command them to be break to pieces now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, God, my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to give you all the glory in the name of Jesus. I am going to pray for you. Any witchcraft bed forced into your chest and those of your family members, I command you to catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. There are bats, there are evil bats that has been forced into your chest. Some people, they are bats. You hear bats are in your chest. They are crawling, they are itching you. I command them to catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Stone marine demons, jump out from your glory. Jump out from your family's glory and die in the name of Jesus. I am praying every marine witchcraft, I command you to jump out and die in the mighty name of Jesus. I am cursing them. I bind them and command them to get out of your life and go in Jesus' name. Yes, God, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you. I give you all the glory. I give you all the honor. In the mighty name of Jesus, my God and my Father, I praise your name. I thank you, Jesus. I give you the glory, God. You are wonderful. You are worthy. You are Lord of lords and King of glory. There is no any other God like you, Lord. My Father, I throw a wall of fire. I cover each and everyone in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, my Father, I pray that anyone being attacked by witchcraft, I cast every spell and chant in their life in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to give you all the glory, my God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you. I bless your name in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, God. Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to give you all the glory and the honor in the mighty name of Jesus. My God and my Father, in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, every witchcraft battle that wants to swallow your life, I command them to die in the name of Jesus Christ. Every garment of poverty that has been programmed by witchcraft, I cast them. I command them to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Yes, God. I want to thank God and give God glory in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, my God. I want to thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, God, you are so wonderful. You are a good God. We love you and we worship you, God. I know that, God, you will deliver people. You will deliver somebody that has been attacked by this witchcraft. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we give God glory that Jesus Christ himself, he said that he has given us power and authority against these works of the enemy. Yes, I know cobwebs. Yes, witchcraft in the form of cobwebs. I command you to catch fire. Catch fire and burn to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, call me. Call me. Our number is 647. Our number is 647-608-5207. Call us this number if you need any prayers, or you can reach us at 905-487-7196. You can reach me. I will pray with you in the mighty name of Jesus. We have a free toll-free number, 877-241-3420. Call us. You can reach me on this number. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhm. Website. Our website is www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. And the email address is overcomersdhm@gmail.com. So you can reach us through email, through our website. All information are there, and we have videos, we have information. You can go and help there. If you want to join the class, you are most welcome. You can join and learn a lot of materials and a lot of subjects that you want to know. If you want to know, to hear about God, the voice of God, you can join the class, and then you learn how to hear the voice of God. If you want to know about the deliverance, you can come and join the class, and the information is at the website. Go there or call me. I will help you and show you how to join the class. Thank you very much. God bless you. I have to stop here. See you tomorrow. Tomorrow, Friday, we have 7 o'clock, our prayer meeting, deliverance prayer. So tomorrow morning, we don't have any prayer. I will have prayer on Saturday morning and Sunday morning. Sunday morning, Saturday morning, 8 a.m. We don't have any prayer, night prayer, midnight until Monday. Monday, we have again midnight prayer. So today is Thursday. Tomorrow, we have 7 o'clock, our deliverance prayer at the Primary City Center where we have our prayers. So if you want to come and join us, you are welcome. You are welcome from anywhere. You are welcome. Call us and we can direct you the place where we are. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. Bye, 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 bye.